This is Inside Blazer Baseball with Head Coach Brian Shoop.
Hey Blazer fans, welcome to Inside Blazer Baseball. I'm your host Heather McGowan here with Head Coach Brian Shoop of UAB Blazer Baseball Team. Coach, it's been 2 weeks since we last talked to you. We've had some on the road and home games. We beat Troy here, beat Alabama on their own turf, and then had a little bit of success and a little bit of struggle at UCF and home this past weekend versus Tulane. If you can sum it all up in a little bit, tell us what you've seen from the guys these past 2 weeks and what would you like to see improve more moving towards this week?
Well, your emotions are usually based on your most recent game, so that wasn't good. Playing Tulane here yesterday. So on the short term, the last 3 weekends, honestly, we've played East Carolina, who's a lock in a regional, Central Florida, who's a lock in a regional, and Tulane, who's a probable in a regional. So these are very, very good teams. On the whole, in the 2 weeks, we're 4-4. With, as you said, a win and a sweep of a series against Troy, and our fifth win in our last six outings against Alabama. So we continue to be very competitive. We continue to not be quite a regional caliber team yet. Where do we need to get better? Honestly, what we felt was our strength. As our pitching staff has been really beat up the last 3 weekends, and our pitching numbers are not very good the last 3 weekends, and for us to win, what we think is our strength has to be our strength. So we need to not be in games where we have to outscore people and win 10-9. We need to be in games where we pitch and defend and piece enough runs together to win 4-3 like we did on Saturday, which was actually a heck of a bounce back win for our team. We have confidence in our guys. We believe they're capable, and with 5 weekends to go, that's where we need to primarily get better. We need to continue to improve defensively. We continue to need to improve situational hitting, and with two strikes. So we strike out too much. We've got to continue to grind and practice on getting better as a two-strike approach team.
Well, we've got another chance to improve this week. We've got a home-and-home with Samford here at Young Memorial Tuesday night, and then away at Samford Wednesday. We've gone 53-20 with them, leading the series over the past 73 meetings. But it's been pretty neck and neck the past few years. So what are we expecting competition-wise from them this week?
Well, Samford's very good. I think the teams are evenly matched. They've actually won the last four, although we had leads late in two of them. We won the four previous to that. So we're 4-4 in the last eight. I think the teams are very evenly matched. Samford's a veteran team, a very good team that I think our records actually are identical this year. And again, it's as I've said with many, it's not a heated rivalry. It's a friendly rivalry. We like a lot of their kids work our camps. A lot of our kids work their camps. Coaching staffs are supportive of one another, trying to help out one another. It's a good midweek rivalry, two good teams, and usually they're very competitive games. Gardner-Webb comes in this weekend. We have a bye weekend in our league. A bye weekend is very difficult to fill in the middle of the season. And sometimes you're to the point where, as we were this year, we just thought we were going to have to take the weekend off. We couldn't find anybody. And then Rusty, who's a friend of mine at Gardner-Webb, they ended up needing some games, so it worked out. You almost take anybody in the country you can. That's how we played at Utah 2 years ago. That was the only team in America that had an open weekend on our bye weekend. So, you take who you can get. Gardner-Webb's a very solid team, very well-coached team, and those would be good games as well this weekend.
Well, Coach, we're looking forward to it. We're going to try to get out here before this rain takes its toll on us. But fans, we'll see you Tuesday night at 6:30 here at Young Memorial Field as the Blazers host Samford. And then this weekend as Blazers host Gardner-Webb, 6:30 Friday, 2 o'clock Saturday, and 1 o'clock Sunday.
Saturday should be a great day. You know, that's our that's Coach McGee's first spring football game. That's at noon. We play it too. So we hope the Blazer Nation will come out and support Coach McGee in our football program, which we're all excited about at 12 o'clock noon. And then make the short walk over to Young Memorial, and we're going to honor Dylan Napoleon Saturday before the game for being the conference pitcher of the week earlier in the season. And you know, our again, whether we're in a win streak or a lose streak, we have phenomenal young men who are, in my opinion, incredible role models to bring kids to watch, who are literally giving everything they have to UAB and this baseball program. So great Saturday opportunity to be a part of UAB athletics in general. So we hope you come out.
Thanks, Coach, for taking the time to talk to us. And we'll be back with more after this.
Okay.
We'll return with more Inside Blazer Baseball right after this.
Football game is set for Saturday, April 21st at noon, live from West Campus Field. UAB fans are invited to set up their tents and tailgate in Tent City. Spots are free and are available on a first-come, first-served basis beginning at 7 a.m. on April 21st. After the spring game wraps up, head over to Young Memorial Field where UAB Baseball will take on Gardner-Webb starting at 2 p.m. Coach McGee and the team look forward to seeing you at Blazer Fan Fest 2012.
Hey Blazer fans, welcome back to Inside Blazer Baseball. I'm here with number 8, Chase Mallard, a right-handed pitcher from Coleman, Alabama. Chase, you've been in some clutch situations on the mound coming in as a closer, especially in the one victory we had over UCF in the 3-game away series there. What goes through your mind when you're put in at the end of the game and it's a clutch situation and the coaches are really depending on you?
I love it. It's really fun. Just go in there and try to dominate each batter. Try to go in there and throw strikes because that's exactly what Coach wants us to do, to compete, really. So that's what I try to go and do every time.
Well, you're a sophomore and one of the younger pitchers on the mound this year, and you've seen a lot of time on the mound. What does that mean that the coaches have faith in you? What does that mean to you that they can put you out there being so young?
It means a lot just because I love to go out there and do it. When the pressure's on, that's when it's really fun. So I think they know that I can go out there and do the job, really.
Well, we're back home this weekend with a 3-game series against non-conference opponent Gardner-Webb, and this is actually the first time we've ever played them.
Right.
Any thoughts going into that game? Do you know anything about their program or what to expect, or what's your mindset for that?
It's just another game. I don't really know anything about them, but if we just play the game and play our game, we'll be fine. We'll be okay.
Well, we're looking forward to that with y'all, and we'll see you back here at Young Memorial this weekend against Gardner-Webb.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming out, Chase.
Inside Blazer Baseball returns right after this. Something good with your money. Refinance your old loan from another lender or get a new loan at Legacy with a rate as low as 1.9% APR for a limited time at Legacy Credit Union.
Hey Blazer fans, I'm here with number 10, Jeff Schalk, a freshman outfielder from Wheaton, Illinois. Jeff, we were just talking about this. You are the only freshman we've had on the show so far, so congrats.
Thank you.
You're also a consistent starter for the Blazers. What does that mean to you, and how does that feel to be so young and to be consistently playing for the Blazers?
It feels good. Really, I just kind of, I'm happy to be on the ball club, happy to, do what I can. Just kind of take a day-by-day approach, and anything I do to help the ball club.
Well, you're helping them out a lot. At the plate, you got a 3.44 batting average, and that's actually leading the team right now. What is your secret when you go up to the plate, and what's your mindset?
I just say, pure, just raw talent. actually, just kind of, I just kind of take a simple approach. I've hit a lot of singles this year, and, not really doing a whole lot special, but just trying to get on base for the team.
Well, it's working. We can see it in the numbers. Now, Jeff, you've never played Sanford since it's your first year, but what have the guys told you to expect from playing Sanford? You got a home and home this weekend. They'll be here at Young Memorial Tuesday, and you'll be at Sanford on Wednesday. What are you expecting there?
From what I've heard, just real good competition. It's going to be a great team play, and they've got some good players. We got some good players, so I think it should be a good battle.
Well, we're hoping for it, and we're looking forward to it tomorrow. And thanks for joining us on the show today.
This has been Inside Blazer Baseball with Head Coach Brian Shoop.